I'm Laine Quintos of Pipe Me Sweet Sugar Confectionery. Just a quick background on my career as a sugar craft artist. I started in 2001, work in Dubai, UAE as a Wilton cake decorating instructor, then as a pastry chef in Singapore and in Doha, Qatar. Alright, now I'm going to do a cookie decorating demo for this year's theme, Dark Gothic Halloween. And for the materials needed, first would be a royal icing, okay, prepared earlier, medium and thin consistency royal icing. Next is our pattern for the Wicked Witch, okay. Then next is a shape cookie dough, okay. A shape cookie dough, this shape 6 by 3 inches, but any shapes will do. Okay, then a brush, then wax paper of any brands, and then a baking tray. Okay, and then gel food colors. Specifically, we're going to use black, white, and brown. Then lastly, we need vodka. Okay, so now we're all set, so let's start. Okay guys, so we will start by tracing ito pong ginawa natin na image, okay, for the Wicked Witch. So what we're going to do is, of course, you draw, then you cut it kung ano po yung shape niya. And then, on an empty cookie base, okay, so you're going to put this on top of it. Yan. Yan. Just put it flat like that, okay. And then what you need is, of course, water and yung brown gel food color. So, lalagay natin siya sa paint palette. Then, a few drops of water, of course. So, we just need to follow yung edge nitong pattern natin, no? So, follow lang natin siya. So, you can start with wherever you want. Yan. So, i-outline lang natin siya ng buo. Okay. This one. Just to make sure to have enough water para at least may moisture din yung brush natin at matrace siya ng gusto. You don't need actually a very dark line for this, no? Yan, parang meron lang siyang shadow of yung imprint, diba? Para later on, pag in-outline natin, madali natin makita. And ma-follow. Okay. Okay, let's go to the other side. Same goes. Outline din natin kung ano yung shape niya. Then, this is actually the cheapest way, no, that you can trace yung images to your sugar cookie, because there are easier ways, like if you have a cookie projector, so that's easier for you, and you have ready-made stencil cutouts, then that's easier for you as well. But for those who don't have, no, you just start with manually trace and draw your image onto your cookie. And lalo na yung mga nasa bahay na gusto mag-start into cookie decorating business. Most especially, it's Halloween, trick or treats, pwedeng giveaways, no? And of course, for Christmas. Then for the final outline, let's just see. It's complete already. Ayan. So, ayan, ready na, no? So, I'm using brown kasi it's parang magkasing kulay lang sila, no? Nung sugar cookies halos, but it's just darker. Kasi pag black, baka humawa siya dun sa other colors na ilalagay natin later on. So, use brown instead. So, next natin. Of course, lagay natin yung details. So, gagawin lang natin. Okay. Koconnect lang natin to for the hat. Face niya. And then for her teeth. For the eyes, of course. Ayan. Then, for the teeth. So, para may pattern kayo, mas madali kung start with the straight line sa gitna. Para you will know where to put yung iba niyang ano, teeth. Ayan. So, it's easier. Diba? So, lagay natin chin niya, of course. So, again, let's start sa center. Ayan. Okay. Now, we have the face ready. Ngayon, punta naman tayo dito sa may bust line niya. So, lalagyan natin siya. Guys, no need na magaling ka mag-drawing for this, no? Just as long that you have a pattern. Okay. So, now, okay, lagay natin siya, yung kanyang sleeves. Then, of course, the hands. Okay. Let's make it a little bit bigger para scary talaga siya, di ba? Then, of course, let's just put some space para naman kay pumpkin. Okay, and let's do the eyes. For the pumpkin, now I'm going to do yung mouth niya. Okay, as for this, so I'm just going to connect this for her skirt. And a few lines just to separate it later to have a two-dimensional effect. Ayan. Okay, so now guys, we're done with the pattern. Okay, then now what we're going to do is we need a medium consistency royal icing for the outline. Okay, you can use whatever color you want. Pero for now, for easier and more convenient way, use white royal icing instead. Okay, so it has to be medium consistency. Then, start piping. Siguro, you can just pipe first yung inner design. Okay. You just follow your, ano, yung pattern ninyo, yung outline, no? Ayan. Okay. The eyes again. Okay, then the teeth. Okay, then after that, the shoulder and the sleeves. Then just to make sure that you get the right consistency of the icing, you have to put ample amount of powdered sugar and then a little bit of water if it gets too hard. So let's just put them out. Okay. Then for the final outline, we do the skirt. Okay. Okay, so that's it. Then we start doing the outline. Of course, we need a wall para hindi mag-drip out ang ating icing, di ba? Then when you usually do your outline, make sure that you stick the tip of your cone or your piping bag onto the dough. Then you really have to make sure that ayan, so nakadikit talaga siya. Okay, so now we're done with the outline. So for color flow, you need thin consistency royal icing. Ito, this is thin consistency. We're going to use this dito naman sa background muna. So 90 degree angle, start piping. Okay, so now when you're doing color flow, make sure that alongside you have a toothpick or a scribe tool, no? For just to easily smooth your royal icing or your flooding consistency. Just continue spreading the icing until you cover the entire green area that's supposed to be green area. You really need to be fast kasi magda-dry po siya, mabilis siya mag-dry. Then we move to the other side. Okay. See? Okay, then that's it. And don't make it too thick, no? Just enough para ma-cover lang yung entire area na kailangan nating i-cover. Okay, so now, we're going to do this one. By the way, kapag ito pong royal icing ninyo ay pre-prepare ninyo mga 3 to 5 hours ahead of time, you see, ang nangyayari, nagwa-water pooling siya. So, what you need to do is just to massage lang yung ating, ayan, yung piping bag para mabalik siya sa dating color. Okay, so this one kasi no need siya to make it smooth kasi hindi talaga siya intended na maging smooth kasi effect niya yun eh, 2D effect niya. Okay, now we're done. Ngayon, dito naman tayo focus sa mismong image niya. We're going to do of course the pumpkin, which is orange. Okay, as for the hat, we're going to use this. So, violet, thin consistency royal icing. But make sure before you start applying another color or contrasting color, kailangan medyo dry na siya, no? Or medyo nag-set na yung first color na in-apply nyo before applying the second color. Okay. Continue pressing. So, So as well as the witch dress. Okay, for the bust, just need to pipe a little bit harder. Yan, for the 2D effect din, ano? Okay, as for the skirt, since meron tayong in-between outline, let's alternate, no, yung colors para at least magkaroon siya ng separator outline. And mas maganda kasi for a 2D effect surface. Yan. Usually for the skull, I use gray, ivory, or kaya plain white. Okay, but for now, since ito yung requirement natin for the subject, we're going to use a little bit of ivory. Then, let's continue piping lang. Then, the chin for the bone. Yan, para sa 2D effect niya. Okay, so as you can see, no, ayan, no, nakikita niyo yung parang imaginary line na may 2D for the 2D effect. Okay, so yan, lalagyan lang natin siya ng black. Okay. And para sa shadow lang ng hat niya. Okay, for the eyes din, lalagyan din natin siya, but a little bit thinner. Okay. Okay. Okay, then finally, lagyan na natin yung sa mouth nitong ating Wicked Witch, which is black din, of course, but gaya sa mata, yun, a little bit thinner dun sa base. Now, what we're going to do, pag natapos nyo na kasi yung inyong color flow, you need to put this in the oven for a few seconds or a minute para at least mag-set yung mga colors niya. Or if you have the humidifier o kaya yung incandescent bulb, you can just always use that to let it set first. Then, after that, gagawa muna tayo nung yung pan-decorate natin sa top niya. Okay, so turo ko muna sa inyo kung paano nagawa yung bones and also for the hair, di ba? Gawa tayo ng 2 icing build up. Parang gumagawa ka lang ng beads. Then, 1 line. Ayan. Then, another 2 icing bead up beads. Okay? So, do at least a few of those para later on. Yan. So, ahead of time, dapat gagawin nyo na to, no? Yung pang-decorate natin sa taas. Now, we're going to do naman yung ating sa hair. So, let it just drop, no? Parang gumagawa ka lang ng, ayan, so, noodles shape, diba? And you have to do a few of those para yan yung lalagay naman natin sa hair niya. Then, now, what we're going to do, of course, is to decorate na, no? Yun sa kanyang final outline. Okay, so for the eyes, magagawa tayo ng dots. Medyo malaki lang, bigger. Now, immediately, you have to, ayan, apply natin yung brown. Okay, then, yung black. Yan, smaller than brown, just a small dot. Okay, then, white. For the reflecting light, really small dot lang. Okay, so what we need for the outline, no, or for the details would be lahat na medium consistency. So, a stiffer royal icing, no, for the outline para hindi siya mag-melt. So, now we're going to start. Now guys, just a tip, no, when you're working with black, you have to really be careful. Kasi pagka yung black natin ay naputol, then hahawa siya sa ibang kulay. Very sensitive ang black. Yan. Okay. Yan. So, parang 2 beads lang siya na heart shape, na inverted. Okay. Then, this one. Okay, then next naman natin gagawin is of course yung wire sa kanyang hat, then overlapping lang. Yan. So, just randomly pipe an overlapping line. Yan, to have that effect. Sa hair. Okay, yung ginawa kanina, yung ahead of time, di ba gumawa na tayo ng eto, yung mga yan, so mga curly hair niya, and then the bones. Okay. So, gagawin natin, lalagay muna natin yan. By what? Maglalagay tayo ng medium consistency muna na yan, na royal icing. Of course, white or black will do kung anong meron kayo. Okay lang. Okay. So, gagawin lang natin, lalagay lang natin siya dito. Or orange. Whatever you have. Orange na lang para same. So, medium consistency. Nalagay lang tayo dito. Yan. Yan. Then, a few of those na ginawa natin kanina. Yan. So, stick lang natin siya. Yan. Yan. So, mamaya, dadagdagan natin siya. Okay. But for now, yan na muna. Okay. So, gagawin lang natin. Yan. So, mag-outline lang tayo. Gaya nung ginawa natin dun sa wire naman dun sa ano. Barbed wire sa kanyang hat. Yan, medyo yung stroke yung kamay ninyo. So, first for the painting, we need, of course, yung paintbrush natin. And we need vodka. Just so you know, guys, pag nagpe-paint kayo, kailangan, you have to dry muna yung entire area, no? Yung etong background niya before kayo mag-paint. Yan, so magbabrush lang tayo. Ayan, dyan. Ayan, some silhouette for the grass, no? Lagyan natin ng grass. Silhouette. Lalagay tayo ng silhouette of a cemetery. Ayan. So, and we have the trees here pala, no? Yung mga branches. Lagyan na rin natin. Fallen with the other side. So, lagay din tayo ng grass effect. When painting onto your royal icing, it's better to use vodka. So, it dries quickly. Yan. So, lagyan lang din natin ng mga grass, just like we did earlier. Okay, so now guys, lagyan na natin naman ng tree. Branches niya without leaves. Yan. niya. So this is what they usually do para mas spooky yung background. Yan. Okay. Then now, so since we're already done with the silhouettes, let's just put some dots. Yan. For the sky effect. For a scary night effect. Okay. Ito naman. So, sa shadows tayo. Ayan. So, for the shadows, when doing shadows, make sure na yung inyong brush is naka 45 degree angle. Yun. Okay. So, para makuha mo yung blending effect. Then, the other side. For a lighter shade, so less the color, more of the vodka. And then next, we're going to do some of the reflecting light naman or the highlight. Ayan. Para mas realistic siya. Ayan. Okay. Then dito sa kanyang bust. Ayan, okay, little bit, shoulder. Okay, send a few dots dito sa kanyang witch hat. And of course, for the stars effect, you use white. If you're going to use white gel food colors, no need na to put vodka on it. But if you do use a pure gel food colors, then that's the time you need the vodka or any alcoholic beverage. Okay, ayan. Then a few shadows lang, no? Dito. So usually black yung ginagamit natin for shadows. Ayan. Para ma-highlight lang yung isang part or isang area na lalagyan natin. Okay, when you're brushing dito sa Royal Ice, especially when it's not too dry pa, make sure that you position your brush at least 45 degree angle to prevent it from breaking. And then, guys, sa kanyang teeth. Okay, so for the teeth, lalagyan naman natin siya ng outline, but we're not going to use black medium consistency outline, but instead we're going to use yung painted, no, na black. So para makita lang, no, na yung may teeth siya dyan. So, dito lang sa side, usually naman ang reflecting light, sa side lang siya kadalasan. Okay. So, now guys, I'm going to teach you, ito yung namang sa kanyang feet. Okay. Yan. You can actually pipe white royal icing for longer nails, no? let's just put some outline here as well. Yeah. Little bit of white. Yan. So parang may effect lang na reflections. Okay. So we're now going to continue naman with etong ang ating hair, no? So kulang pa yung hair natin. So lalagyan naman natin siya ulit ng didikitan natin siya ulit ng yan. So konti pa. So medium consistency royal icing. Yan. Okay, put another one here. Then ito na yung ginawa natin kanina. You can put more, as many as you like. Yan. But not too much lang, no? Kasi hindi na kasha. You just need to always consider the area na paglalagyan ninyo. Pag not enough space na, then that's it. Para hindi naman siya maging over-decorated. Now, we're going to put the decorations on top, which is yung ating bones. Yung ginawa natin kanina. So, what we need is, of course, this one, yung ginawa kanina. So, I have them ready before we start. Okay, so we need now the medium consistency white, so we can start piping and sticking the bones naman on top, diba? So first we start here. Yan. Okay. Then we stick some of the bones that we've done earlier. So let's choose a little bit bigger. This one. Yan. So, didikit lang natin siya all over. So, better if you pipe a line, no? Para hindi kita yung iyong pandikit. View of it. Okay. More sa other side. Easier if you have tweezers, guys. Okay, lastly, so pipe another line. So I have a bigger one right here. Okay, so now we're done. Yeah, so okay na. So for the final outline, we need also green, medium consistency for the leaves. So just cut it small. Yeah, so cut it small. Then you just need to pipe some here. Press and then pull. Yan. Don't need a lot. Just in between lang nung bones ninyo. You have like a small leaf effect. Okay. So guys, eto na yung ginawa natin for now. Okay. So this is my featured theme for their dark gothic Halloween theme of the year. So eto na po yung sugar cookies and final output natin. Okay, so that's it, guys. So this is the final output. Thank you very much for Creative Cakepreneur for inviting me to do a demo and to showcase our product. It's been a privilege, and thank you for all the support. So please do like us on Facebook, Pipe Me Sweet Sugar Confectionery Products, and on Instagram at Laine Pipe Me Sweet. And to all aspiring sugar craft artists, my message is just be patient, as every day will be a learning process. So keep on practicing, and you just need to love what you do. So thank you very much, guys, and I love you all.